Donegal. Go ahead, Phil.
Salam alaikum, brother.
Alaikum salam. Thanks for ringing, mate.
As ever, worth the wait. Listen, I think I've got a really, really good what-if hinge factor for the 20th century.
Mm-hmm.
A really cracker. But if you indulge me just for a second.
Yeah.
I know you are a very inveterate and committed anti-racist person.
Yes.
And you are, you know, Scots born of Irish descent. All that's out in the public domain. I interviewed a young man last week in my job as a journalist. Called James McCarthy, who plays for Hamilton Academicals.
Mm-hmm.
I witnessed that young boy getting racist abuse. He's an Irish citizen. He's chosen to play for Ireland.
Yeah,
okay?
Yeah.
The visiting crowd was St Mirren. He got appalling abuse today from another club we won't mention.
Mm.
Right? Appalling abuse. And he's 17. He's legally a child. Made it onto Sky News. I just want you to know about that.
I didn't know about it. It made it onto Sky News. And
it did. It made
was
it onto Sky News text where it said that James McCarthy, the Ireland winger, right, which is legally correct, he's like myself, an Irish citizen, he carries an Irish passport, and a lovely lad, had been racially abused throughout the game. Now, I won't mention the club, because that might give you a problem, but there's a clue, is they haven't won the European Cup. Okay?
I think I know where it happened, and it's a disturbing thing, Phil, and you and I have spoken about this before. As I said, if people were singing at Tottenham Hotspur, "The Holocaust is over, why don't you go home?" If they were singing at the Arsenal to the black players, "Slavery is over, why don't you go home?" It would be on CNN. It would be a scandal. It would be an international scandal. Yet, week in, week out, Irish players, even not Irish, but Irish descent players, are being subjected to the racist song, "The famine is over, why don't you go home?" And nobody in the Scottish Football Association is doing a damn thing about it. Am I right, Phil?
George, thanks. That's brilliant. Thank you for that. Listen, I interviewed Lex Gold and Gordon Smith last week for a piece in the Irish Post, and they said that they couldn't do anything because the clubs involved, and we won't name them, were doing all that they possibly could to educate their supporters. So let's cut that because it's depressing, but here's one that might have turned out a bit better.
Uh-huh.
Here's my hinge factor. I think the hinge factor of the 20th century happens in Munich in 1920. Okay?
Yeah.
A member of the police there, the armed police, drops to one knee and fires into a crowd, and he wounds one Adolf Hitler.
Mm-hmm.
What if he'd have killed him?
That's a very good one. That would have made a big difference.
You know what I mean? And they were told to open fire, obviously, in the crowd, to kill the crowd. Because
yeah.
They were armed. It was a Munich putsch. What would have happened if that, you know, nutter had been killed?
Mm-hmm.
So, finally, mate, as ever, a big hail from all at Celtic Minded. You're a brilliant guy.
Thanks, Phil. I appreciate that very much. And that's a very interesting hinge.